Hey guys, welcome back! Let's revisit this baby, the 50 Shades of Orange that I won a few months back from Deckard Games. Gonna make some changes to it, cause if you recall, it wasn't fully working. So, and besides some hardware upgrades, for this video I also partnered with Software Keep to bring this project to life. And while I assemble and configure this mighty rig, let me just explain what Software Keep is all about. Software Keep is a Microsoft certified gold partner who sells 100% genuine Microsoft software. That's one of their promises to the software buying public. They only sell retail keys with top-notch 24/7 customer support all year long. They're based in the United States and Canada and have been active for over 5 years. During this period, over 100,000 customers rated their service 5 stars. 100,000! All purchases are secured and safe, while all products are approved to be on the shelves by Microsoft, and they will help customers on every step of the way, even after the sale. In their customer care service, you'll be talking to real people, not robots, with a full 360-degree software buying experience. Their number one goal is to give customers the very best service, genuine products, and some of the best prices. They provide helpful content on how-to and tips and tricks to help those in need, not forgetting an online chat, so that you can get your answers faster. They offer lifetime and subscription products from one user to enterprise licenses, such as Microsoft Office, Office 365, Windows, Windows Server, and even all sorts of antivirus software for PC and Mac users. All purchases are covered by the money-back guarantee policy, so if the product does not work, you can request a full refund within 30 days by simply contacting Software Keep via email or by phone. That's it! Several payment methods are available, from PayPal to debit card, and the estimated key delivery is 15 minutes or less. And most importantly, on top of these already discounted prices, you can get an extra 20% off in the entire store using the affiliated link in the description and the code PXEL20. So, what are you waiting for? No need to go to those illicit websites to get software that might come infested with malware that will destroy all your data and even your system. Be smart! So, about the specs of this rig. It has an Intel Core 2 Duo inside, 2GB of RAM, an NVIDIA GeForce 9600 GT graphics card with 1GB of RAM, and an HDD combined capacity of around 450GB, basically. Now let's try and run some of my favorite PC games from the early to mid 2000s, and why not, older than that, so let's do it! Starting off with an off-road racing game, obviously, Insane is among my most played games ever, and it brought these free-roaming off-road environments that are still a blast to explore nowadays. It was the first game to use Codemasters multiplayer network, and I used to play it a ton online with friends, but also in LAN parties in the early 2000s. Yeah, it was released back in the year 2000, and I've already reviewed it a few years back. Check it out! And what about Crusader No Remorse? Ah, what a game! Another of my biggest addictions back in 1995, alongside with Star Wars Dark Forces. Curiously, played a lot this one, but not as much its sequel, No Regret. Guys, which one do you prefer? Tell me everything down in the comments section below. Doom 2 is one of those games that must be always present in everyone's hard drive. At least on every system I had throughout the years since its release, Doom 2 was always ready to be played. And another type of games that must be always present on every system I own is pinball. In this build I installed, for now, Epic Pinball, an absolute classic among the classics. If you recall, practically every single pinball video game would come published by 21st Century Entertainment. This one comes from Epic Mega Games, and the full version would offer 12 tables in total. Yes, 12! Initially in 3 separate packs of 4 tables each, and a couple of years later, the full experience on CD. Way before Wreckfest, there was Flat Out. I recall following closely the development of this game because all the mess and environmental destruction really grabbed my attention. And it was, with no doubt, completely different and engaging from everything else made until then. Stuff like Gran Turismo 4 that was released in the same year as Flat Out really annoyed me because it was impossible to completely destroy the cars, not even mentioning the fact that in Flat Out, the driver could be tossed out of the vehicle in head-up collisions and even in minigames. So much fun! Check my full review! Hexen was another huge deal for me back in 1995. In fact, just like its predecessor was. 1995 was such a great year in gaming, and I recall spending hours after hours playing this game because of its medieval setting and gloomy sound effects and music. Like Heretic, it was created using an enhanced Doom engine and also allowed vertical looking and flying. This time around, the player had 3 characters to choose from at the beginning of the game: the fighter, the cleric, and the mage. Which one was your favorite? Tell me everything! And what about Ignition? Did you play it? If you were exclusively playing games on consoles back in the day, most likely you've never heard of it, because it was only released for PC and Mac. It has that Micro Machines vibe and can be equally as fun as that series, but because it never came out on consoles, it was quickly forgotten and never received a sequel. The Emperor's Tomb was the last good indie adventure, and I really miss a good adventure featuring the man in the hat. Since 2003, that everything bearing the Indiana Jones logo isn't worthy of that badge and respect. Maybe the upcoming movie and game from Lucasfilm and Machine Games can change that. I'm crossing my fingers. As for this one, it was a huge addiction for me right back when it was released. Bought it for my PC when it came out, and I was completely overwhelmed by this incredible adventure. It was a worthy sequel to the also incredible Infernal Machine from 1999. Ah, Jazz Jack Rabbit, the Sonic killer for PC games. Another gem coming from Epic Mega Games that blew everyone's mind when it came out, first through a shareware version with only the first episode. Gameplay and music are top-notch, and was what really made a difference in relation to everything similar that came out during that period around 1994. Another computer exclusive that should be experienced by everyone, and if you play it around Christmas, the game gets a Christmas theme with snowflakes falling on the main menu and several new backgrounds. Lastly but not least, Moto Racer by Delphine Software was another huge bomb that arrived first on PC and a few months later on the PlayStation, but let's face it, the PC version was way prettier than its console counterpart. My camera is not picking up these white backgrounds in this snowy track, I'm sorry about that. But this is such a fun game to play even nowadays, performing those wheelie stunts just to go a bit faster than the rest of the bunch. Ah, damn it, what an awesome afternoon playing these jams! And obviously that Winamp should also be installed and featured. Again, check the link below and use my exclusive 20% discount code to get some genuine software for your PC or Mac from no less than a Microsoft Certified Gold Partner. If you've enjoyed this video, consider supporting the channel monetarily through Patreon at patreon.com/itsapixelthing or using the thanks button below. To keep up with what's going on with the channel, check all my social media stuff by clicking on the link in the description. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you all in my next video. Cheers!